crowd. He meant a lot to the Michigan people as a whole. And he's the only person, as you can see, even in spirit, that is able to unite all these wrestling promotions in the greater Michigan area. UConn Braxton, even with his death, is still making an impact on the wrestling team here in Michigan.
He most certainly is. American kickboxer.
Drew Martini trying to avoid Josh here. Lock it up.
There's certainly a strength advantage.
Oh, most definitely.
Here. You figure the threat's going to take it to the air.
Yeah, well,
at some
Brett's
point here.
Kind of a little bit of a smarter attack of going after the middle of Josh.
Getting the bread basket.
Yep. Ripping into the ropes. Drew Martini coming off. Oh, we have Samoan drop into a backbreaker by Josh Mobile.
Drew Martini looking in the wrong corner for help.
Oh, yeah, he's definitely in a bad way at this point in time. And going to his own corner, reaching up. And making a tag.
He found nothing but a barrage of chops to the head.
Anthony Rivera didn't seem too anxious to tag in there.
Yeah. Bump and Uglies stirring up here in this capacity crowd.
Fans get behind the Bump and Uglies. Josh Lovato. Give it to Josh Lovato. A guy built like his size and his size, using that lower center of gravity to his advantage, able to move around there for a big guy.
He most certainly is. He is a, one might call him a brick. A brick. There's a word in there that I'm not allowed to say.
I understand completely.
What if I call it a brick feces house? Ooh, and a chop.
Right between the shoulders. A little more alarming, kind of shocking, Josh.
That's one way to break on that.
Double boots by the Bump and Uglies.
Oh, here we go.
Being double, sending it in the rope. Double elbow by the Bump and Uglies. And Bubba McKenzie in control of the situation. By Bubba.
Gravity is not Anthony Rivera's friend right now.
Yeah.
Spending most of his time on that mat.
Yeah. Bubba McKenzie in control. Front face lock. Looking in suplex by Bubba.
Ooh.
Bubba in control.
A scintillating suplex.
Ooh.
Bubba getting out of there before Truth has a chance to, I won't say cheat.
Give Bubba Ugly credit at this point. They're keeping the match at a slower pace, more to their style, kind of using their powers, a little bit more methodical than
They're certainly tagging well to keep Truth Martini out of the
Double leg drop.
One must leave the ring right now, that's for sure.
Over 400 pounds dropping down on the arms of Anthony Rivera. Anthony in trouble right now.
Josh.
Another big punch.
Some close fists.
Josh with a chop in Anthony Rivera's chest. Another big chop by Josh. Oh, he returning the favor. Anthony with a Josh in the rope. Drew grabbing Josh.
Oh,
Josh's attention. Josh,
come on, Rev.
Oh, Martini in the smoke. Turning around.
The punch never lies.
Whoa, look at the power. Look at the power of Anthony Rivera actually scooping Josh Lovato into that scoop power bomb.
Anthony doing more than anything else but buying his team some time right now.
Almost definitely.
Letting Truth get back to his feet. Let him regain his breath there.
Oh, yes. I think the threat needs to speed up this pace a little bit. It'd be more to their advantage. Going up the more methodical of the two.
These bumping armies are, slow and methodical.
Truth
taking it to the air.
Throat of Josh Lovato. Josh Lovato in trouble in the back and throat area. Oh, big forearm shiver to the jaw of Josh Lovato. Josh right at his back and Truth with just a short knee to the forehead of Josh Lovato.
That knee will actually cause pressure on the brain to sometimes make you lose memories.
Most definitely.
Oh, and a huge turn of events for Truth Martini with the big elbow.
Martini able to switch up his momentum in that middle of that maneuver. Give Truth Martini credit.
Truth going up top.
Going up top.
On a staggered.
Oh! Fist to the forehead of Josh Lovato.
Come on, ref. That's a close fist.
Josh Lovato definitely in trouble at this point in this matchup. Flat on his back. Truth Mike Martini and Anthony Riviera able to take control of the situation. Chris Butler boosts to the solar plexus.
Moving Josh up on the way.
They charge it. Boost by Josh Navarro.
They should have seen that coming.
Look at the big man fly.
That.
Yes, Josh Navarro coming off the second level of double clothesline. Bubba Sparks, Bubba McKenzie, excuse me, trying to provide encouragement in the corner for his partner.
He's calling.
Right now.
For his bandmate as well.
Oh, most definitely. Trying to pull it together is Josh Navarro. Take his ABC roll.
Oh, Bubba. We got a hot tag here.
Bubba coming in just a house of fire. Big chops and punches to the head of the track. Tagging in Josh
Navarro. Just tagging left and right.
The bearing ram.
Oh.
I've seen this once before.
The Bushwhackers is the Bumpin' Uglies.
Look at that.
Bushwhackers never been known for their good looks, and neither is the Bumpin' Uglies, and their name says it all. Bumpin' Uglies out on the floor with Anthony Rivera and Duke Martini. In control right now are the Bumpin' Uglies.
Wow, they're taking the action out of the crowd now.
Oh yeah, there's no getting away.
Anthony Rivera has a chair.
Slammed head first into the rail by Josh Navarro.
That's the steel guardrail, mind you.
Definitely, the Bumpin' Uglies in control at this point in time in this matchup. Josh Navarro coming up.
Oh!
Andy Rivera with a chair to the back of Josh Navarro.
Oh,
the threat in control at this point in the matchup.
Those Bumpin' Uglies sliding a table in the ring.
How quickly the tides have turned in this matchup. The threat in control. Set up a table inside the ring.
Oh!
Second of the Bumpin' Uglies in the head with the chair.
And other members of the Bumpin' Uglies taking chair shots.
Right now,
Bubba's calling out to set truth to that table.
Bubba's in control on the outside. Anthony on the outside in control.
Bubba
going up to the roof.
Those
ropes. Yeah, these guys are definitely got to be tired this point in the matchup.
That's a big man to be. Oh! That's it!
A chair to the head of
Bubba. Ladies and gentlemen, Josh Navarro has been eliminated.
Josh has been eliminated.
No, they didn't know the names. That was Bubba McKenzie. That was just
Bubba McKenzie.
Josh Navarro.
There we go.
The Truth Martini. Scoops Truth up. He's got two set up. Oh, this is definitely trouble for Truth Martini. A fall out Mickey Ledger pile driver. And a chair to the back.
Josh actually compressed Truth's vertebrae in such a way nature did not intend.
Oh, most definitely. Anthony Rivera hit Josh Navarro on the back with a chair.
Anthony Rivera.
We're raising the furniture at this point in time.
He's getting creative here with the table.
Trying to rearrange the furniture the way he wants it.
Josh is hurt.
Yeah, Josh is definitely in trouble. Big chair shot to the back, slows the big man down. Anthony Rivera setting up the table in the corner. Has to feel in control at this point in time in the matchup.
All right, here we go.
Anthony Rivera able to scoop Josh Navarro.
That's a big man. That is a big man.
He's setting his man up.
What is this?
This could definitely be trouble.
Whoa.
Josh Navarro.
Hitting at the table.
Whoa.
Oh, he puts down the brakes.
Josh turning around.
Oh!
From the table.
Anthony Rivera.
We're down to two.
We're down to two people. Josh Navarro and Truth Martini. Truth Martini waiting in the corner. Double clothesline.
Ooh, that's the wind out of their sails. What's this? Is this Amazing Nate?
Amazing Nate
making his way to the ring.
Why is Amazing Nate coming to the ring?
He's going up top. What is this? Amazing Nate.
Oh. Three quarters of the way across the ring by Amazing Nate. And Josh Navarro is definitely in trouble at this point in the matchup. Mavaro laying flat on his back, apparently unconscious.
Amazing Nate looking for the last table. Maybe there's one set up.
Oh, maybe not.
Amazing Nate bringing a table into the ring.
There we go.
Wait a second, Briar Wellington coming up.
Briar Wellington, he's been with the Bumpin' Uglies as of late.
Briar Wellington
helping out the Bumpin' Uglies.
Briar Wellington. That is uncalled for. I think we have a new member of the threat, and that being Briar Wellington.
Briar just ending his friendship all in one fell swoop with the Bumpin' Uglies.
Josh Mavaro in trouble. And Drew Martini coming up, shining wizard to the face of Josh Mavaro. Josh Mavaro.
This brings back all four original members of the threat here.
Exactly, and Josh Mavaro is nothing good for this big man. Flat in his back as the threat set up the table. So seemingly getting ready to eliminate Josh Mavaro for this matchup.
As we all know, this match is completed once the last person goes to
Josh
the table.
Mavaro.
That's a lot of weight to put on that table.
Anthony Rivera's
got him up.
Thank you.
ECW.
Then the ECW, WCW, WWF, he said FMW in Japan, and there you see him, the alpha male, Ronnie Brown, coming out to the ring. This is about to be a matchup. When I say there are big men in professional wrestling, they don't come any bigger or any tougher than that man, Ronnie Brown.
I would not want to bump into that man in an alley, that's for damn sure.
Yeah, this is going to be an interesting matchup. The Suicidal Homicidal Killfire, Sabu. Definitely, just because of his brand of wrestling, the way this man wrestles, he has no regard for his own body whatsoever.
Let alone others. Let alone other bodies.
Most definitely.
Monty Brown, huge pride.
Got caught with a single leg.
Sabu snapped that ankle, though.
Now he's going right there. The extension points at the knee as he was moving it in. The knee and the hamstring where the extension points at Sabu. Monty Brown
tearing away at that loose tape.
Monty Brown complaining to the referee who Sabu might take in the shortcut.
Ain't no half step in here.
Monty Brown tucked under go behind, taking his man Sabu down, rolling him up.
Oh.
Amateur wrestling by Monty Brown, impressive amateur wrestling. Trying to keep Sabu a bit off balance.
Sabu's body is...
Whoa, look at this. Sabu! Bar. How impressive is that?
That is great.
The homicidal suicidal
Deadpool. Monty, huh?
Yeah, very impressive wrestling right by Sabu. Sabu, usually the crazy one, flying from all the areas and went to a single leg at that point. Working on the leg, he's trying to wear Monty Brown down. Oh, two big punches.
Gotta chop that
three big punches
down.
By Sabu. Another big punch by Sabu. Monty Brown blocking, going to the solar punches of Sabu. Moving into the corner, big two, three big punches by Monty Brown, and Sabu's in trouble.
There's Sabu in the corner. Meet the five fingers.
Another punch to the head of Sabu by Monty Brown.
Wearing him down.
Sabu getting whipped into the corner again. Getting out of the way.
Out of there quick.
Going up. Whoa, Monty Brown catching the power slam.
Racing pageantry, that is Monty Brown.
Big power slam on Sabu. Monty Brown showing why he is the power man in professional wrestling, as he is. Going for a pinfall.
Two count, didn't hook the leg.
Yeah, most definitely. You've got to hook the leg against the veteran like Sabu.
Didn't hook the leg.
Yep. That's a bit of arrogance on Monty Brown's part. In there against a veteran like Sabu. Double underhook, butterfly suplex by Monty Brown, going for a pinfall. Again, not hooking the leg. I think he's taking Sabu a little bit for granted, you might say.
I don't know how you could. Sabu is as classic as his uncle himself.
Oh, most definitely. Twice as dangerous as any man in the sport today. You never know what to expect from a guy like Sabu. And Monty Brown just going to work, trying to immobilize Sabu, going to work on his back. Sabu in trouble. Monty Brown just stopped
the
way.
Follow-away slam. Beautiful follow-away slam.
Tossing it away.
Monty Brown.
Tossing it away like yesterday. Garbage.
Looks like he's tossing Joey Harrington.
Oh, no. Monty Brown hit the leg that time. Monty going right to work. Just a simple punch to the head on Sabu. Living Sabu in the rope. Sabu. Half flipping over. landing on his feet. Drop kick of Monty Brown's leg.
Tree down.
Monty Brown stuck with a springboard leg drop.
Taking it to the aerial assault. That's one way to beat Monty Brown.
That's what we were talking about before. Sabu.
He's going to need a lot more than that, though.
Yeah, he's not as powerful as Monty Brown, but he is double dangerous just because of the risks that he takes.
Uh-oh. Sabu's counterpart, his manager, if you will.
Sabu pointing to the sky.
Brandishing a chair. Baseball slide.
Drop kick by Sabu. These fans might be smart to get out of the way at this point.
Oh, no. Could this be the triple jump? Look out, fans. Here we go. Oh, one, two. Whoa, not quite enough.
Sabu building up his momentum.
There he goes into the crowd.
Triple jump by Sabu.
Taking it to the crowd.
Sabu built up his momentum on that second time up. He didn't have enough momentum the first time. He carried himself over the top rope and be as offensive and as dangerous as he wanted to be.
They just took out the first three rows of chairs over there, and there are only three rows of chairs over there.
That's what we were talking about before. This man has no concern for his own body. It's Sabu going right into the chairs and right into the crowd going after Monty Brown.
Monty Brown still keeping his head on his shoulders.
Yeah, the alpha male, oh, going to work on Sabu. Big forearm to attack.
See, you just made him angry.
Yep. Sabu.
Sabu up top. Oh!
His foot draped across the rail by Monty Brown. Monty Brown showing that strength advantage.
Sabu didn't need that jaw anymore.
Oh, most definitely. Sabu's had problems with his neck and jaw before. This man's had more concussions than I've got fingers and toes. And definitely not good for his forehead and skull. Sabu slamming the head.
Oh.
Take Sabu into the jaw of Monty Brown.
That mat not is in a chocolate cover.
Oh, no, no, most definitely not. These guys fighting it out on the floor. Monty Brown trying to slide in. Sabu with a boot to the back of Monty Brown. They're putting a boot to the head.
Big boot. Monty Brown kind of wondering what day it is.
Most definitely. Sabu punching Monty. Got him set up in the corner, whipping him into the corner.
Oh, oh.
With him there, big blow by Sabu, taking the head.
A pin.
Taking the head of Monty Brown.
Down the leg.
Yeah, he took Monty Brown just the head right off.
Oh, he's just kicking him in the spine now.
Reminiscent of his uncle, the original Sheik, with the camel clutch on Monty Brown. Referee Brian Gorey asking
Brown,
if he
had yet.
Sabu cranking away at the neck area. He knows the pressure normally of a camel clutch is at the center of the neck. He's cranking to the side of the jaw, putting the pressure at the jaw, the ear, and the neck area.
Oh, look, what is this? What is this? He is so strong, that Monty Brown.
That's the power we were talking about.
He just picks him right up.
Oh, he stops Sabu on his head.
On his neck.
Sabu landing directly on his head. And Monty Brown showing the power that he's got, being the alpha male Monty Brown, the big powerhouse that he is.
He's in April somewhere, folks.
Oh, Sabu, definitely. It was days of bewilderment. Seeing a little bit of the birds and the stars, and Monty Brown just putting a boot to the solar plexus of Sabu.
And that is certainly not what you want to look up to when you come to it. Is a man of Monty Brown's stature. Two count, don't hook the leg.
Oh, definitely. Hooking the leg this time.
Oh, still yet a two count. Sabu's a fighter.
Yeah, Monty in control of this situation. Big right hand to the jaw of Sabu. Two, that's the way you come out spitting out chiclets, millionaire. Somebody blast you in the mouth like that.
Certainly is, certainly is.
This is my mom.
Oh, one way down from there.
Whoa, Sabu. That's the power we were talking about, millionaire. Able to scoop Sabu from a hurricanrana and slamming him down into a power bomb.
Both men out of breath, gasping for air.
Sabu with a possible
pin. We got a four count. Oh, my ball with pin. Two count, two count.
Sabu right now, as I said before, possibly suffering a concussion.
Didn't hook the leg on either one.
Taking a lot of offense from Monty Brown directly to the head and neck area. Monty Brown being as big as he is, that's definitely not a good situation for
Monty
Sabu.
Monty Brown taking him to that glass jaw, Sabu.
I wouldn't say that he's got a glass jaw, millionaire. That man's taking a lot of blows to the jaw.
I think one match Sabu taped up his glass jaw after RVD broke. broke it with
a glass jaw is not the proper wording for that. A glass jaw is a man who can be knocked out easily. Peruka in boxing. This is a contested athlete in Sabu. Sabu hooking him up. Sabu getting a chair in the ring. And Cosby,
he just throws that steel chair at him.
Pretty much covers
him. Still a two count.
Ronnie Brown getting drugged to the middle by Sabu. Sabu setting up the chair. Certainly not good for Ronnie Brown. Caught Sabu's leg as he was going past.
Monty Brown was watching the tapes before the match here.
Almost definitely. He seen the chair set up, knew nothing good was coming from that. Monty Brown.
Monty Brown
picking up the chair.
Using the chair himself. Oh!
Sabu in trouble. Monty ripping him off to the ropes. Coming off the ropes. Sabu head first into the...
He plants him into that chair.
That's a conscious millionaire. This match is over with. 1, 2, 3. It's a, Sabu able to kick out.
Sabu said,
Able to kick out after coming directly down on his head into that chair. Sabu getting whipped across, tied up now. Sabu is taking a lot of damage to his skull area, and the homicidal manic.
He just blasted him.
Monty Brown.
4th and 10, you're not punting.
Yeah, most definitely Monty Brown finding his quickest way to the cornerback, and that was through Sabu. And Sabu on the outside, definitely in trouble.
He blasted him completely out of the ring.
Now, Monty Brown, that's what we're talking about, the power of Monty Brown.
That's the power.
The first is the unpredictability, the craziness in there. The high flying of Sabu and the power right now is definitely taking effect.
I believe they said he was 270 pounds.
If he said, she sent me, it's not 300 pounds for you, I'm telling you.
Of all brute strong.
Yeah, this player is not an ounce of fat on the body of Monty Brown. Sabu
with an uppercut.
3 big punches, 4. Whoa, Monty going right back to the...
You can hear those punches all the way over here.
Oh, most definitely.
Double axe handle.
Guys are true athletes out there. Monty Brown, the alpha male. Sabu takes it. He's seen him coming with that sack type maneuver from Monty Brown.
Not the best of that, apparently. It was Monty Brown. Sabu with a 2 count.
Sabu smacking Monty Brown cross-eyed with a chair.
Sabu's calling for it.
It's a definite trouble for Monty Brown. The chair gave way. Sabu,
he doesn't need the chair, folks. 1, 2, 2 count.
2 count only. Monty Brown.
Apparently that chair helps him that much. He would have gotten a 3 count if he used the chair.
Oh, he sits on Monty Brown's face with the chair. Maybe a face buster from Sabu. 3.
He learned that one from the sheet.
Sabu, your winner here for Proper Practice.
Of this eternal championship title belt, and then next year,
presented by the winner of tonight's Battle Royal, JJ Ford.
Oh, there it goes. Oh, there it goes.
Monster Meter and Chuck Wagon crushing Violet Barrow.
Wrestlers.
Chuck Wagon.
Here they come in droves.
Tommy Starr knocking Shaggy. Nope. Being saved by Violet Jade. Tommy Starr still swinging at Kimbo.
Super Meaty's still in there, getting his ass kicked by Eddie Venom. No pun intended. Oh, put that away there.
Get the old Tommy Starr. Going to work on the ice.
Put that away.
Join where his talent lies.
Our esteemed colleague, Mr. Michael McMahon, making his way back up here.
Mike McMahon.
Jones's nephew has been thrown aside as well.
Right now,
Mike McMahon back with us.
You got us. You saw me out there.
We saw it.
Who eliminated?
I believe it was Kamikaze.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was Donnybrook.
I brought him here today.
Well, you guys, since you're sitting down in the ring, we've got the Insane Clown Posse. We've got TC.
ICP certainly in the driver's seat. Oh, but not much longer. He didn't touch the bottom. Violet J still alive.
Violet J holding on to the
ring. Kamikaze and Super Meaty can't quite get him out. Shaggy Trudeau's currently getting pulled by Clark, who's already knocked out. Clark should be back in the locker room by now.
Mr. Meter, the guy who I picked in the beginning, the windows, standing up the middle. Oh, he just hit. That's the most time.
What about this Chuck Wagon? He's about the same size as me.
Wagon's still plugging along. Eddie Venom bringing a huge splash to Kamikaze in the corner there. Oh my gosh, Shaggy Chudo getting a hold of the Kano stick. ICP, we got Big Chuck Wagon, Kamikaze, Mr. Meter, and
Super
Meaty is still tearing it up.
Mr. Meter sizing up Shaggy Tudo. Shaggy pulling down.
There goes Mr. Meter.
That was my pick for this.
Wow, I have to say ICP is.
Oh, Chuck Wagon!
Here we go. We're down to two men. Hype, Jimmy Shaolin, and Kamikaze. And a big elbow chops him down.
Over 20 minutes. It's now down to these two gentlemen.
Mr. Meaner trying to convince us he was screwed.
I don't think Clowns should be in it anyway.
If anyone was screwed, it was ICP because they came out.
I can't believe it.
Whoa. No one heard that back at home on the DVD. Hype bringing Kamikaze the hard way down. Where is he going?
Hype going up.
Battle Royal. No one goes up top during a Battle Royal.
A popular mathematics.
He certainly is.
Look at that. He's smiling. He missed the boots up.
That was
Kamikaze.
Kamikaze plants him.
Can he get rid of the hype?
Hype taker's time getting to his feet, going to
Kawakami. Oh, Kawakami.
Oh, they called that.
Oh, wait.
Oh, wait a minute.
Did he make it?
He's holding on.
Kamikaze.
This certainly thrust Kamikaze to the top of the ranks here in the IWR.
Your new Utah Braxton Memorial Champion, Kamikaze. Tim, what can we say? What a great battle royal. And we're going to be right back with more action right here at the Boston Braxton team with the American Kickboxer and the Billionaire.
We most certainly will.
As you look at the crowd here, they're kind of in a stunned silence right now.
Oh, watch this, watch this. The rest of our men seem to be pouring out from the back.
Whoa.
What is that? We got Necro Butcher. And we got Paul Morbid. Oh, Necro Butcher with the barbed wire bat. Hitting.
Brain damage in trouble right now.
Oh,
Butcher,